Welcome to this interview, but before immediately starting, I'd like to explain some things first. It's already quite a while ago since my first video got published, at the beginning of this last year, my second half of my year in New Zealand, as well as the half year being back in Osnabrück, which is my home city in Germany, passed. I'll be interviewing three teachers where we're talking about these special subjects or subject options, which are pretty unknown for the German students. However, the footage shown is only going to cover a small piece of the whole territory or area of the school. So first of all, the following interview with Mrs. C. Hanley is all about the topics computing, programming and, which is going to be pretty interesting, the history of all the technical developments with regard to computer technique they went through. The next interview with Mrs. Strulik is about the creative part and which options you are able to choose. This sector, which isn't really dealing with computers, is called Hard Tech Department. Everything is about working with wood and metals, where you can develop your ideas even further into real models. Besides all of that, Mrs. Strulik also teaches some other subjects as well, like photography for example. Unfortunately, I've been unable to take these classes, because I had to meet the requirements of my German school I received because of staying a whole year, but that's what I basically had to trade in for staying longer than lots of others. Last but not least, I'm interviewing a pretty cool teacher, as you will see later on, who's really enjoying teaching his hospitality classes. I don't want to reveal too much, just have a look. Alright, so far so good. If you have any questions, just contact us, or if you're interested, me as well, of course. For further information, just have a look in the description. Let's go. Nice to meet you. Thank you for agreeing to the interview. So I'd like to ask you, why did you choose to teach this subject?
I've always been interested in commerce, and it's a passion of mine. And one of the things that we did start off with in the old days with technology, it was typing. So all students at Rangitoto College originally had to learn how to type, touch type. Then we progressed into word processing, and in the 90s the computer came along, and that's why we are now teaching computing. At the present time it's a 10 ICT class, and we are teaching them gaming. They're learning to make their own games. They're given 7 weeks in which to do it, and then they will all play the games that the students have made, and it will be tested. We're using Game Maker 2, and it can be, it's a free game that you can get off the internet.
That's pretty cool to hear. The history of the typing on the typewriter.
Yes.
Until the development came, and nowadays that you're writing on the computer. It's pretty interesting to go through these chapters while teaching.
We change our topics on a very regular basis, which means that you've got to upskill yearly. New subjects, new topics. We teach word processing, Access, Excel, Dreamweaver, HTML websites. In the generic computing side. In the other side is the design work for the seniors, and then there's the programming.
I really like the fact that you're actually producing your own game.
This is something that's just come in the last 12 months, and all year, it started in year 10, and all the students are learning how to make games. The new initiative in New Zealand is from year age 5 right through, is that children will learn to use the computer, and we're just staging it right through to the senior schools.
So can you imagine that at Rangitoto College there are so many different classes or subjects being offered for all the students compared to definitely less in Germany? How about the differences in the years, especially when you want to decide which subjects you're going to choose in New Zealand? What are you going to do in this, which years?
Yes, in year 10, which is this class now, they it's an option class. They choose to be in this class. At the end of this year, they then have several different things that they can opt for, either going into programming, which they've had a little bit of a taste of. They've done design work using Dreamweaver, Photoshop, Illustrator, web design, or they can go into generic computing and just do the basics of computing, which will help them when they go into the workforce, or if they go to university using just Word, Microsoft Word.
So your normal lesson, as far as I got that right, is the kids are programming their own code or with the software?
And yes, they've been given a set task to do. They've got to actually design the game. They've got to make their own sprites. They're little people that are jumping around all over the screen. They're making their game. They can do it either in Game Maker or another program, Unity. They have to sketch the program. They have to design it. They have to test it. And then they have to produce it. They've got a certain time to do it, and then all the students will play the games, test it themselves, and then I mark it as well. Yeah. It's quite involved, but they're having fun, so that's the most important thing.
Thank you very much for your interview.
Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Have a good day.
Safe trip home.
I'd like to ask you, like, who you are and what you're teaching.
I am Strulik. I teach construction, materials technology, and photography at Rangitoto College.
Awesome.
Currently, we're in the technology department, and I have the construction class next door.
Cool. Okay, so you're teaching probably different years. Which things are you going to do, like, in the year, I don't know, for example, 10, 11, 12, 13?
So, depends what subject, but at the moment, for example, my year 12s are doing stools at the moment, and they're going to be doing tables later on this term. The year 10s are going to be doing making clocks and designing clocks for the next project. My year 11s are currently finishing off some lined jewellery boxes where they've had to follow plans, and my photography group have just finished shooting a documentary project in the city.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Kind of regret that I couldn't take these subjects. Sounds really interesting. Because back in Germany, we don't have those subjects. We have more like the standard subjects.
Yep.
And I think it's pretty interesting to hear what Rangitoto College is offering. What do you think about Rangitoto College with all these different subjects with regard to specializing in the interests?
I think it's a really good school to come to if you are wanting to be exposed to a different variety of subjects, in particular the more creative subjects like the arts, and the more practical subjects like construction and engineering and furniture making, because we offer those. In regards to the arts, I think we definitely have a strength in those in terms of the music, the visual arts, drama, dance, soft technologies as well, so that's textiles, hospitality, food technology, and I think a lot of other countries might not necessarily offer those as options. The fact that it is a huge school can have its advantages, because it means that there will always be someone you can get along with. The location is pretty all right, especially when you look at the view from the top field. Where the maths department have an amazing view of Rangitoto Island. It's close to the beaches, and most people that come here live really, really close to the beach.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think that's what makes it really, really special.
Thank you. With regard to the subjects, you mustn't forget that's all besides the normal subjects we know back in Germany. So it's a lot of different subjects.
Yeah. Yeah, cool. Definitely.
Thank you very much for the interview.
No worries.
You're doing the hospitality class. What are you doing there?
So we've got food technology and hospitality. So upstairs we often do food technology, and that's part of the technology curriculum. So it follows the making concepts or coming up with products that fix problems, and then going through that whole process. But it's based around food as opposed to other materials like soft materials or woodwork and stuff. That's what we do in food tech. And then downstairs, often in year 12 or 13, we offer hospitality, and that's more skills based, and that's more about cooking or making different types of foods, and yeah, cooking and eating food.
So you're actually cooking food in class?
Yeah, we do that in both classes, more so in hospitality, but in both classes we'll cook food and make food in classes, yeah.
So for example, what are you cooking?
So with my year 9s in here, what we done was we took an existing product, which is a My Food Bag. So it's a bag of food that's sort of prepped up but not cooked, and it'll get dropped off at your house, and then you have something, a recipe for each day. And then what my year 9s done was we made some food bag foods, and then we came up with our own designs and made our own food bags, and then they designed their own, prototyped it a few times, and then they gave it to other groups to make. And so they made a little recipe card and a couple of put everything together, and then the idea is you just grab the bag, grab everything out of it, it's got a recipe, and you just follow it, and then food, dinner's done.
That sounds
stuff
pretty,
like that.
Yeah, sounds pretty interesting. In Germany we don't have these subjects.
Yeah.
We just have like more or less these standard subjects.
Yeah.
So where are the differences from year 9, 10, 11, 12, 13?
Differences in what do we do differently with the subject as they go through?
Yeah, well, for example, you were talking about the prepared food packs.
So it starts off like things as simple as like food packs, and then in year 11 we do things like preservation, so they'll make things like jams or chutneys or things like that, and they're all made or based around from year 11, 12 and 13, they're based on unit standards or achievement standards, and so yeah, depending on, we'll take the unit standard or the standard, and then they'll do something like preserve foods and stuff, and then we'll choose products based around that. So I know some other groups, they've made things like different types of chocolates. We've done some preserving. There's often with food technology, often it's a lot of like making a product and then getting some feedback on it and improving it. So we'll make one product and add to it. So sometimes they get a bit sick of doing the same thing or making something, then adjusting it and then remaking it. But yeah, it's part of the process, I guess.
Sounds good though.
Yeah.
All right. So what do you think is special for Rangitoto College with regard to these subjects besides the normal ones?
Yeah, I think Rangitoto, like one of the best things having a massive, like being a really large school, is we can offer lots of variety. Yes. So each of the students, they can do anything from like particular types of, like anything from drama and dance to lots of extracurricular sports and things. And food tech and hospitality, they're both really good, interesting subjects for students that are interested in that, and they can follow both of those things, and there's like careers and pathways through either university or more industry based like pathways that you can follow with them. Yeah.
Alright, that sounds pretty good.
Cool.
Thank you very much for
Thank
your
you so much.
Time and for the interview.
Appreciate it. Yeah.